versatility.
Okay, stop now, stop. Totally unprompted. Good evening, welcome to the Lenny Henry Special. My name is Special, and we're going to have a good time tonight because it is Christmas time, it's the season of goodwill, it's time to party. Are you ready to party?
Yeah!
Let me hear you say party, say it.
Party!
Say. Say, shut up, Len, get on with the show. Anything when they're in a crowd, because this is a party crowd, isn't it? Can you feel it? It's a party crowd. We're going to have a good time tonight, but we have to be careful not to make too much noise, because the neighbours are complaining. We've got Doctor Who in the studio next door. We'll have the Daleks coming in saying, excuse me, lovey, would you mind awfully keeping the noise down? We can barely hear ourselves exterminate next door. Because that's how Daleks talk when they're off stage. But you are typical party people, I can tell. You're the kind of guy who turns up at 6:30 with a can of lager and walks out at midnight with a bottle of scotch. You're the girl who ends up crying on the lawn. People come up and say, you all right? You go, I want to die. Meanwhile, your boyfriend's upstairs rolling around on the couch with your best friend. And you're the kind of guy who passes out under the sofa. Nobody knows where you are until 2 weeks later when they empty you out of the Hoover bag. Terry, you all right, Terry? Then, of course, the music comes on, all your favourite hits come on. Bros, drop the boy, drop the boy. How about from a 40-storey building? Ah! Yeah, good one out recently, I quit. Good! Then Rick Astley comes on. She wants to dance with me. I think she wants to see whether he can dance at all. He's horror. Have you seen him? When I fall in love. Meanwhile, his black friends are off camera going, Rick, you've got to get busy. But you're a party crowd. You're responding well, I can tell. You see, people do things when they're in a crowd that they wouldn't do on their own. For instance, you wouldn't walk down the street singing, here I go, here I go. You just don't when you're on your own, do you? Crowds can be very threatening. You've heard of football hooligans, now they've got chess hooligans. They stop you and surround you and take an hour and a half working out where they're going to hit you. Yes, very good. The big crowd puller of the 80s, of course, was all the charity events that went on. I think charity's very worthwhile. But I think it's very unfair that the general public have to keep digging into their own pockets to raise money for things that they should be entitled to anyway. You know what I mean? I think it's very, very unfair. I mean, pretty soon if you want to have an eye test, you're going to have to swim 50 lengths or abseil down a tower block. If you want to have a heart transplant, you're going to have to do a sponsored bed push across the Himalayas. Some guy's trying to raise money for a hernia operation, he's got to drag a grand piano up the post office tower. I mean, the armed forces don't have to do this, do they? You don't see Wogan organising the telephone, welcome to squaddies in need. Now, last year, we raised the princely sum of £4.50. Now, come on, we can do better than that this year. Dig deep, because these soldiers haven't got any weapons at all. Do you realise how long it takes to beat the enemy to death with a stick with a balloon on the end of it? It takes ages. Actually, it'd be quite good if they had to do that, because nobody would contribute and they wouldn't be able to afford a war. Mind you, they'd probably have sponsored regiments then. Like the 5th Battalion Hitachi Paratroopers. The Queen's Own Pizza Hut Highlanders. The My Little Pony Household Cavalry. Katanga, my friends. Welcome to Joshua Yarlong, Satellite TV. Oops. Mistakes, my friends. We all make them, especially at this, the cutting edge of technology. Yes, good day, cobblers. It is me, Joshua Yarlong, Africa's best-known broadcaster and satellite supremo. Because, yes, that is correct. JYTV is the world's first, foremost, and bloody brilliant pirate satellite TV station. Beam, beam, transmit, transmit. Okay, my friends, can you guess where we are transmitting from today? Yes, that is right. Los Angeles. I wish they all could be. No, my friends, just kidding, because we are really coming from Wales. Yucky da. I seek them. Leaks. No, my friends, just kidding. Because we are really coming to you live, all the way from Australia. Ready to beam you 24 hours of non-stop filth and quiz shows right into your home. Deregulate, deregulate. Enough to name. All right, my friend. First up in the filth world is our brand new sexy quiz game, Bank Your Cards Right. Ignore him. He is Paul Hogan. Ziggy, I told you about using this sticky tape. It is crap. All right, my friends, never mind. Beam, beam, Murdoch, Murdoch. Over here in Australia, neighbors, Kalimanoch. It's back over the year's best film releases, because I am Barry Norlog, Britain's best-known film chooser. And why not? The first big film release of the year, and why not, was a film release called Big. And why not? It is the story. Why not? A 35-year-old man who gets trapped in the body of a 12-year-old boy. No, Ziggy, not him. He is a 12-year-old boy. Get back over here. The next big major motion cartoon talking picture was a film entitled Who the Hell Was It Who Framed Roger the Rabbit Anyway? It is the story of a rabbit who gets framed, but we here at JY Satellite TV can out Spielberg Spielberg because... Yes! We can afford a real rabbit. All right, Roger. Who the hell was it who framed you? Come along, speak up. Old talk, eh? Well, there's more than one way to skin a rabbit. All right, my friends, this is time for some cartoon slapstick. Don't worry, my friends, it was just a dummy. The real rabbit is right here.
Oh, no,
don't worry, we'll get him another one.
Everything you've got, taking a break from all.
Afternoon, everybody. I just shot my wife so I could sneak out for a beer. Maggie, Nanny, maybe I should get married so you could shoot my wife so I could sneak out and have a beer. Hey, Clippy. See that beautiful blonde who came in after me? I think she's smiling at me.
Yeah, careful, Nanny. Last time I thought a beautiful woman was smiling at me, she was just pulling out a dentist to polish him on his sleeve.
Man, I'm trying to destroy my liver here. Hey, Carla, how'd your date go last night?
It speaks. I thought somebody threw up on a bar stool.
All right, give us the lowdown on Mr. Wonderful.
What's it to you, moose breath?
Isn't this wonderful, Clippy? Who said the art of conversation was dead? I think it's time for my 19th beer of the day.
And to think I could be home right now, de-lousing the kids.
Oh, guys.
Hi, Sam.
Way to go, Sam.
Look at this. Gee, more TV awards. Where are we going to put them?
No, don't worry about me, Sam. I can handle this. Back home, I carried around a prize pig for a week, but it died. I guess I should have put it down for its feed.
On the bar, Woody. Woody, get off the bar.
What a guy.
Hey, I just found a couple of dead cockroaches down here. That reminds me, where's Diane?
I think she's in the office. You want me to call her, Carla?
Yeah.
Hey, Carla.
What a putz.
Oh, wow, Diane, you look absolutely wonderful tonight. How'd you feel about coming back to my place? We can rekindle our romance. I've got a flamethrower with your name on it.
Sam, although sexually you might have the qualities of an Olympic athlete in his prime, intellectually you're more like a starting block.
I think she means wooden, Sammy.
Hey, by the way, this came in the mail.
It's called a letter, Cliffy. I think you ought to know that, being a mailman.
You want me to post it?
I'll take that, Woody. It's best to give it to someone who can read.
Hey, Diana. What is it, another TV award?
Oh, hey, wait a second. You're crying. What's up?
Sam, it's from the sponsors. They say it doesn't matter how many TV awards we win, we'll never be as successful as the Cosby Show. So they're gonna fire all of us and replace us with an entirely black cast.
But I am black.
evening. My name is Deakus. I come from Arm. When I come to England, the first thing I noticed was the fog. I said, what the hell is that? Somebody said, that is a real pea super. I spent the entire day walking around London looking for the dumplings. It's always raining in England. Rain, rain, rain all the time. I bought some money over there that I'd save for a rainy day. It was gone in a week. In Jamaica, the weather is so good. If you save money for a rainy day, by the time you're 6 years old, you can retire. But I'm not doing so bad. I got a little part-time job. It's a good job. It's a good, good job. It's a good, 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 good job. I'm a caretaker in a comprehensive school. Those children are very advanced, you know. They're always nipping behind the bicycle sheds. And I know exactly what they're doing behind the bicycle sheds because I used to do exactly the same when I met Claudine. But she was very strict. She made me buy a bicycle first. After we got married, she had a bicycle shed built in the back garden, special, just so we could nip behind it. We had three children that way. And a moped. Claudine left me, you know. After 15 years of marriage, she left me. One day she said, Deakus, there's another man. I said, who is it? She said, anybody else. But life is different without Claudine, you know. She used to keep me warm at night. Now I've got a hot water bottle, it's not the same. I've tried to make it get up and do me a huge breakfast. Then jump back into bed for some lovemaking, but it just doesn't want to know. Mind you, neither did Claudine. You know something? I think people care more about the whales than they do about whole people. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go down to the local pond and get trapped under the ice. Everybody will be concerned for my welfare. The Russians will send plankton on wheels. I'd be on the TV news. Yes, and Deakus is still trapped under the ice. Hedwina Curry says he'll be all right as long as he wears a extra pair of socks. Thanks a lot, Hedwina. You're a big help. Actually, living under the ice isn't such a bad idea. It's probably warmer and drier than this place.
Ladies and gentlemen, my very special guest on the program today. Will you please welcome the very, very glorious Misha Paris!
Thank you.
Thank you. Some big highlights of the year for me were the Olympics. I was glued to the whole 2 weeks. It was great when Britain won something, wasn't it? Shooting's a big favourite round our way. He hit something else, did he? Mind you, you've got to be fair, they did win some medals, though. It was great. I think that's the way Britain could win more medals, by actually combining shooting with sprinting, you know. The starter's gun goes off, our guy's gun goes off, and he just walks across the finishing line, you know, stepping over the dead bodies, you know. Give me that gold medal! Start the clock! My favourite was Greg Louganis, the American high diver. Did you see that? When he bounced off the board, sailed up into the air, did a somersault, and then bounced back off the board with his head! I'm sorry, I laughed my conkers off. That was so funny. He went into the water like this. The commentators went crazy. Well, looks like a new move has been into his repertoire there, Dave. Maybe he'll get extra points for the stitches, I don't know. The next guy came on with a big helmet on like this. I thought they were a bit overzealous with the old drugs testing this time round, didn't you? They went a bit too far, you know. I had a limpsip once. That's it, you're banned for life! The noble Ben Johnson, I mean, was he cheating? I don't know, was Ben Johnson cheating? Not as if he got on a motorbike, is he, you know? Mind you, they didn't test him for motorbikes, so he probably got away with it. Well, I can't see any traces of steroids in this sample, but there's a bloody great Harley Davidson in here. Sport influences fashion, you know. I went to a club the other night and everybody was wearing those tight, tight cycling shorts, you know. They're all there going, acid! In their really tight cycling shorts. I mean, they haven't even got a bike, these people. It's ridiculous. Why do they wear them so tight? I mean, it's pure exhibitionism. Why don't they just wear cling film instead? It'd be a lot cheaper, plus it'd keep everything fresh. I don't go into all this fitness business now. I take it nice and easy. I go swimming down the local baths, tap my underwater Sony Walkman, whop in a Prince cassette and dive in. Swimming down the baths, you know. They split all the pool up into different lanes, like a fast lane, a medium lane, and a slow lane. It's great, just like a motorway. Old age pensioner jackknifes into the fast lane. There's a 100-yard tailback of people treading water. What the bloody hell's going on up there? Where's the ambulance? The one thing that got up my nose about the Olympics as well, another thing that got up my nose, I've got a lot of nostrils up here, was the fact that there were never any Jamaican show jumpers. Where is the Jamaican show jumping team? They'd never win because they care too much about the horses. Listen, if you don't want to jump it, just walk around this side, all right?
His name is Dwayne. This is my Actually, it's New Jersey. My name is Duck. John Duck.
John Duck?
Damn, gets me every time.
I'm Eddie Nelson, drug squad. And you might as well know I don't want any trouble.
Listen, buddy. I've been hunting this Sicilian sleazeball for the last 5 long years. He shot my best buddy in the back. Thought it was me because he was wearing my jacket at the time. I love that jacket. And he just can't do invisible mending on herringbone. Now, we know the Sicilian likes ladies who treat him rough. Who play percussion all over his little body. So all we gotta do is check out the classiest madame in town. Find out if any of her belles and we have been with him.
Stop doing that, you're making me nervous.
Okay.
Pick up at the Dorchester, anyone? Dorchester, over.
Red Shirley, I'll be there in 5 minutes.
Red Shirley, room 507, spanking and baby oil on account, over. Roger. Anyone manage a quick Roger in Bayswater?
Police.
Sorry, darling. Girls are very busy at the moment. I could do something for you in half an hour.
Listen, sweet cheeks. We're looking for a guy called the Sicilian. He likes the rough stuff. Here's a description. I want to know if any of your girls have been with him. Now, we could do this the nice way, or we could do it my way.
There's a girl called Caress. This is where she lives.
And that's another pension policy that matures next year. Oh, and this is my life insurance with bonuses. And I've got a couple of endowment policies, so I'm pretty well protected, really.
Listen, I got life insurance, too. You see, in New York, you live rough, you eat rough, you sleep rough, and you die rough. That's why I live in Cincinnati.
You got any kids?
Yeah, I got one. Wing the sucker in the leg as he ran out of a liquor store.
I've got 3 kids. 2, 5, and 7.
Kind of strange names for kids.
I have to change them every year.
This could be the Sicilian.
How'd you know?
Just a hunch.
Now what?
Now we wait.
Would you like a cup of hot chocolate?
Come on, man, we're professionals. We've got to be alert.
What that bastard's done to my Garfield.
It's gone 8:30. She should have been out of there by now.
Yeah. I mean, how long does it take to flagellate someone and walk all over them with high-heeled shoes?
About 45 minutes, usually.
Toast?
That includes toast.
Nah, we've lost them.
You never heard a last number redial?
Oh, that's really clever.
Kid Top Hotel Brighton, can I help you?
Yeah, you got a murdering, low-down, scumbag, drug-dealing Sicilian booked in there tonight.
What, the one who shot the bloke in the herringbone jacket?
That son of a... He's in Brighton.
E tutto pronti, Nila Casarani?
Si.
Leva chista ducti in cuto la spada mia. Puo mitilo a dormire con le pisci. Essi sono troppo nitti. Io pensavo che questo era più.
E lei sa troppo.
Natri, guidiamo al mare. O ammazziamo la ragazza d'oro.
What is that? Looks like a stray subtitle. We must be getting close. Come on.
What did it say?
Drive to the sea, girl. We will kill the front bear.
Sneeze! Freeze! Springer!
Springerby? Come on! If you hadn't stopped to pick up those subtitles, we'd have been here sooner.
Evidence me, old son. What's that? It
was a Jack Russell.
Hey, about a nice salmon salad? It won't take too long, you know.
There's no time.
Better than I'm spilling the dressing, yeah?
You realize he was gonna kill you?
You realize he was gonna kill you too?
Well, at least we've got something in common. Let's do lunch.
Good idea. I guess you saved my life.
Yeah, but let's talk about something more important. Do you want salmon hollandaise?
I've already been on my hollandaise.
Frascati?
No, Sicily.
Oh, Sicily? He's getting away! Sbrigati!
Great, you've got me 10p.
Hold it right here! Damn.
Lost.
Get out of the way, will you?
Du weißt doch, dass alle von dir reden.
Warum?
Dein neues britisches Auto. Es ist besser als der scheiß Rover, den du hattest.
Not even to show up, he got away.
It's okay. I know where he's gone.
Good. Here, see if you can do any better.
I've done a doggy bag for this.
Geography, history. Stab! 10 years I've waited for this. You slimy, low-down scumbag. You killed my best friend. You shot my best jacket. You wear imitation crocodile shoes. I hate that.
And now we go to the Luxembourg Journal.
No, wait, you can't kill him.
All right, I won't kill you.
Va bene, non ti ammazzo.
I'm gonna torture you slowly.
Ti torturo, piano piano.
I'll tie you upside down.
Ti rigo capovolto
la insieme. Until you have to beg
for mercy. Ti picchio fino a che non chiedi perdono.
I'll show you pain you never imagined.
Just a minute, that's no good. That's what he pays £500 a night for.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll hand you over to the authorities.
Ti metto nelle mani dell'ordine e della
legge. I'll let them deal with this.
E che se ne occupino loro.
I'll let justice prevail.
Che vinca la giustizia.
Doesn't that feel good, John? You finally realize that it's possible to keep law and order without sinking to the same depths as the criminal. Violence isn't always necessary.
Maybe so, but... That's for Garfield!
Yeah, serves you right.
Crud. Well, just this once.
So Caress, £500 a time, that's nearly $1,000. Maybe you should buy me lunch.
Wildebeast. Hey, my name is Theapolis P. Wildebeast, and I'm a soul singer, baby. You know, I'm so very sexy. I was born sexy. I was born so sexy. The midwife gave me a phone number, y'all. Tattooed it right on my nappy. You know, I'm a real man, too. My chest hair is so thick, the royal family are in there right now shooting grouse. It's a great pleasure, Mom. I'm here making a brand new album. It's called If the Ice Cream Don't Melt, You Ain't Doing It Right. But wait a second, I'm hungry. Hungry for love. I need a woman to satisfy that love. The kind of woman who can percolate coffee with her hips, y'all. I think you know what I'm talking about. I need to find her right now.
Is it? No, that's just the bald guy again. So many pretty ladies in the house. I think it's this lady right here. Give her a big hand, y'all. Come here, girl. Come up here and sit down. Your name is Jill. All right, Jill. We're gonna get real big. Leave my codpiece alone, girl. That's where I keep my money tonight. Hold on. Close the door and dim the lights. Pass me some oil. It's gonna be all right. Well, I'll need a marrow, a big carrot too. Yes, that's right. I'm gonna cook for you. I wanna give you sweet tender loving. You won't guess what I've got in my hot oven. I'm a pressure cooker, baby. I need to let off steam. You're my safety valve. I think you know what that means. I hope you're working tonight, Jill. Otherwise, I'll explode all over the kitchen. We don't need that tonight. Cause I'm a love chef, I'm gonna cook for you. I'm a love chef, cause I'm a cordon bleu. Girl, I can do it boiled or fried, yeah. Ain't no way you're gonna leave the house tonight without being satisfied, Jill. Now, I want you to just calm down because I can feel you boiling over with excitement, Jill, all right? Turn the heat down. You see, love is like a casserole. You spend hours chopping up all the ingredients, you put it into a big pot, and then you simmer until the meat is real tender. Wait a second, that is a casserole. Let me sing the song to you one more time. Let me show you how good I am, Jill. I'm a five-course meal, not a small order. I'm a soul food man, come and get my love, yeah. And when it's over, you'll be glad you stayed. The table's not the only thing that's gonna get laid. I'm talking about cutlery, Jill. Damn, wait a second. I don't need no long meal. Normally I get a boil in the bag, stick it in the microwave, it's ready in 10 seconds. That's the kind of guy I am, so I don't need you, Jill. Give her a big round of applause for being a real good sport. Jill, y'all. Thank you, girl. You see, Jill, when you're on the road as much as I am, you don't need no long, extravagant meals. So I'm just gonna go back to my luxury hotel room, order room service, maybe have some Twiglets. Maybe I'll just lie back and play with my cheesy Watsits. I think you know what I'm talking about. My name is Theapolis P. Wildebeast. Grab this. Thank you, Jill.
Well, the Lenny Henry Show.
Welcome back, my... Zilif, what is the matter with you? This is not Acid House video. Snap out of it. Up here.
Welcome back, cobblers. You know, now that we are so deregulated here in Australia...
This is Hendon.
Shut up, mother. It is time to cut to some super sexy commercials. Zilif, over here. Where are my jeans?
They're in the fridge.
Who put them there?
I did.
Mother, get me a blowtorch, quick. Hello. I am the incredibly sexy woman who has just moved in next door. Smirk, smirk. I have come to buy her some coffee. Smirk, smirk. Oh, really? I'm not so bad looking myself. Smirk, smirk. Coffee, eh? Smirk, smirk. Yes, Smirk, smirk. Oh, smug, smirk. Go and buy your own coffee, you scrounging witch. All right, my friends, forget sex, forget filth, forget porn, because now it's time for even more sexy, filthy porn. Deregulate, deregulate, when we present our brand new quiz game, Master Bunk. Boost that power high, Tundi. Oh, no, too high, Tundi, too high. Oh, God, oh, God. Forget satellite TV, my friends. This is satellite TV.
And with the A-team.